request for National Guard assistance not approved at the same time you approved the expansion of the perimeter?
And during that call, we all agreed that the intelligence did not support the troops, and collectively decided to let it go. Michael Stenger then said, how about we put him on standby just in case, and that's what we ended up doing. But from what I remember, everyone was very satisfied that we had a robust plan, security plan, that was consistent with the intelligence that we had at the time.
Mr. Irving, you said in your testimony that when asked for National Guard assistance, you approved it. Mr. Sun stated that he asked for the National Guard assistance at 109, and you approved it. It was approved at 210. Why would it take an hour to approve National Guard assistance on your part in that moment of crisis? Mr. Irving.
Senator, from my recollection, I did not receive a request for approval for National Guard until shortly after 2 p.m. when I was in Michael Stenger's office.
All right, let me get that straightened out. Mr. Sun, do you know when you asked for National Guard assistance? Was it 1:09 or was it 2 p.m.?
It was 1:09, sir.
1:09.
No, I did not get a request at 1:09 that I can remember. The first conversation I had with Chief Sund in that time frame was at 1:28, 1:30. And in that conversation, he indicated that conditions were deteriorating. He might be looking for National Guard approval and approval of our mutual aid agreements with local law enforcement.
In a moment like this, if you're focus is chiefly on the safety of House members, and I would certainly understand that, and Mr. Stenger's is chiefly on the safety of Senate members, maybe that's a problem here where the board really can't function as a board because you have such diverse areas of immediate responsibility. But whatever happened here doesn't seem to me to be in agreement with the various timeframes,